Haven't you got your first game at 10th, like, in a week's time? Yeah. Why? Have you got your army ready? Yeah, look, took me like a whole week to paint some cactus tyrannids. Have you got something to play it on? You got this 6x4 gaming mat. Have you got any terrain? Oh. No, I don't. Whatever will I do? Welcome back to Lizard of Doom. I am Max. I needed terrain fast. I couldn't be building plastic sets and painting plastic sets up in time for my 10th edition games. So I had a little look at what was on the market that is kind of fast terrain, and I thought I'd bring you a review of whatever I settled on. I had seen this terrain before, and I had considered using it when I played a Song of Ice and Fire miniatures game, because they make a lovely Viking village set, and that would be Craster's Keep, if you know your Game of Thrones. Perfect. I contacted Battle Systems, and they agreed to send me out some sets so I can show you how it looks, how it works, how it feels, and use it in some of my games so I can get a real kind of vibe for it. And now, it's time to let you know how it is. The kind people over at Battle Systems sent me out two kits and a little taster of some of their other kits, but these are the main two that they sent me. The Trader Encampment retails at £49.99 Great British Pounds, and the Outlanders Core Set retails at £84.99 Great British Pounds. Are they worth that much money? Let's have a look. The first thing I've noted to show you is that these two boxes each come with a 2 foot by 2 foot neoprene gaming mat. So this is really good actually if you're going to be playing something like, what's it called? Kill Team, or something of that size, a skirmish game. And they actually do their own skirmish games, but I'm reviewing these for Warhammer. You get a nice desert one for the Outlander set. That is really nice. I do like this one. And for the Trader Encampment, you get a bit more of a dirt and futuristic civilization vibe. This one does have squares on it, which may be useful for some role-playing games and some skirmish games. And each square is actually an inch, so it kind of defeats measuring if you're playing something like Kill Team on this. Pretty useful. Next, everything comes on these die-cut cardboard sheets. The quality of the images on there are really nice. You'd like, not pixelated at all, very high-quality print. And the punching is pretty damn good, and everything comes out pretty neatly without any tearing, which is something I was concerned about. But this is doing its job really, really well. Now these builds are either held together by folding them and then slotting them all into place, or they're also held together by these plastic clips. They've got various different angles and various different types. These smooth ones were my favourite to start with when building, because you couldn't see them as much, and the greys and kind of brownie colours do blend in with the buildings quite well, you'll see in a minute. These ones have a specific ridge on them. If you're building multiple floored buildings, it keeps everything in line and helps everything kind of stay in the right place, because there's little notches in the bottom of stuff. These were very, very useful. I'm not getting paid for this. Like, I just really actually wanted to try this stuff out, and I thought you guys would like to hear if it's good or not. Now, honestly, I would prefer hand-built and painted scenery, but for the person with not much time, is this worth the money? The speed is key. Speed is key. Is this worth the money for something that's going to be fast and able to fill a table quickly? I'm going to time me building one building from these sets now, and you can see for yourself. Go. There are no physical instructions with these kits. It is all on YouTube. Now, this can be a little bit hard to follow sometimes, especially because they are kind of home done. I don't want to undersell them, but they haven't got the massive studio kind of production of a Games Workshop video. A lot of the kits are kind of intuitive and you can kind of self-lead through them, like I've done with these. Some of them on YouTube do have different names for the videos than what they're known as now. I'm assuming that these products used to be called something else or came in a different kit with those names. So it can be a little bit confusing to guide yourself through, but it is easy, as you can see. I'm nearly done and I'm just under 6 minutes in. I'm not even trying to speed this, I'm taking my time making sure everything's bent correctly and that the roof fits perfectly here. Done. Having no instructions can lead to not knowing where things should go, such as the box art. Whoever built these for the box art didn't know where the inside support should go, and they're just loose on the floor on the actual box art. So yeah, maybe instructions. This is the one I've just built now. You can pop all the windows out and all the doors on these kits, so you can block line of sight or keep line of sight through things. It's a nice little feature of these builds. And all the roofs come off so you can see inside as well. There are alternate variants of this in the kit. You've got this nice one on stilts that I really like, and it provides a lovely little sniper spot for your miniatures to sit in. This is the full kit built. This is what you get in this kit. It is a lovely little set. Lots of little scatter terrain as well as the big terrain. This provides a kind of engrossing feeling in it, and a lovely little set of ruins. You know how much of a fan Warhammer players are of ruins at the moment with the current 10th edition rules. Next, we've got my favourite mat out of these two sets, the desert mat, and we need to make the Outlanders set. So this is kind of build what you want, it feels like. There's a couple of things like this watchtower that are specifically built like that. But out of the set, I made a couple of little garages like this, one open so you can see all the way through it. And another more closed variant, so you can block line of sight better, and with a set of stairs, so you can get on top a lot easier. And also, there's quite a lot in this kit, so I made this massive line of sight blocking building. This thing is truly colossal. You can hide Wraith Knights and Chaos Knights and everything of that scale behind it. This was the icon of my game day. This was the centerpiece of the board for every match. You can go up here into these floors and every little bit comes apart so you can see where everyone is in the building, layer by layer. This helps with gameplay immersion greatly, as you can see through every layer of the floor. You can fix line of sight through the building and it is perfect for Warhammer. I specifically chose to leave this corridor open down the bottom so you can see all the way through the bottom, so people can fight at a ground level through it, but it has higher level blocking for bigger models on either side. You might be wondering, Max, it fills those little 2x2 mats perfectly, and that would be good for Kill Team. What about an actual game of Warhammer? Would it fill something like the Leviathan free battle board that came with it, or other things like that available from Games Workshop? Well, yes, it does. This is too much terrain for this. I had some games with my friends over the last weekend, my first experience of 10th edition, and had a good time, but we played on this and we did not use all this terrain. This is too much terrain. The big building is very good as a center line of sight blocker. And apart from that, we use little bits kind of scattered around the edges, little high bits, little bits of ruins, and it was chef's kiss, perfect. So we know it more than fits a board that is this big, but this board is 30 inches by 44 inches. Those are weird sizes, Games Workshop. Does it fit a 6x4, which is your classic Warhammer gaming table? Yes, it does fit on a 6x4. Now this board is 6 foot wide. That's almost as wide as your mum. This is definitely enough terrain to have a game of 40k, like a larger scale game. There's enough room for everything to move in between. So this altogether is about £130. Let's look on the Games Workshop website and see what we could get in plastic terrain for £130 from our overlords G-dubs. You can get one platform, one broken wall, two walkways. Not a lot. Now, it's time to rate this stuff. I'm going to do more reviews like this. I think I'm going to call them lizard looks. Does that sound like a thing? So the lizard look on this. Bring that camera closer, it's a bit too far away. For ease, I made all of this terrain in a day. So it gets 5 lizards out of 5 lizards on ease. For looks, I'm gonna say 3 lizards out of 5 lizards. It's cardboard, so it looks like cardboard. The print on it's very nice. If these edges do irritate you, you can go over them with a marker pen or a little bit of paint and blend them in a bit nicer. But this is all about how fast you can put a table of terrain together. One day. You can do this in one day. Durability? I mean, it's very good that it comes apart and you can see in there. But, I mean, it's a little bit delicate. So I'm also going to give that 3 lizards for durability. Put that back on there. For practicality, I'm going to give it 6 out of 5 lizards. Because you can pack it away and flat pack it when you're done. You can store this in a shoebox. This whole setup, a whole gaming board worth of terrain, you can store in a shoebox. That's pretty good. Real world application for gaming, I'm going to give it 4 out of 5 lizards. It is really good that you can take each floor apart and it feels so much more immersive. And you know, when people are in buildings, they're in buildings and you can do line of sights properly and everything. That's really good. It's a little bit wobbly, you know, because it hasn't got the weight. So that's why it's lost a lizard there. But I would recommend this product. As I say, I reached out to this company, Battle Systems, and asked them for a review set. They sent me these 2 sets, and I would like more suggestions like this from you guys at home. What other small companies would you like me to review within this hobby space? Could be painting, could be gaming. Let me know what you'd like to see, and I'll shoot out some emails and see what I can get my hands on to review for you like this. So I will see you on the next Lizard Look. It's been great. Here is my Patreons. Join them. Please join them. I spend way more on this channel than I earn from it. And if you don't want to send me money for being a tit on the internet, you can always just subscribe and enjoy me being a tit on the internet as and when you feel like. Let me know what you think of this terrain. Is it something that you would use, or would you prefer to stick to the plastic? Thank you, Battle Systems, for sending this out. And remember, it's not a pile of shame. It's a pile of future fun. See you next time. That's the end. Bye.